So now let's see the components of a centrifugal pump. Now most one is the impeller. The impeller is a rotating body, have a series of backward curved blades. As we discussed that the blades are always backward curved with lesser than the 90 degrees angle. Okay, these are mounted on your pump shaft. This pump shaft rotate with your motor, electric motor. Casing. Casing is airtight chamber which surrounded with the impeller or with covered with the impeller. Okay, when your spiral or volute, we call diffuse type. So in this condition, the casing are gradually the cross section area will increases. So the cross section area of casing will increases toward the outlet, that is pump inlet. So where the liquid enters to the pump. So if you see this diagram, so this is called your pump inlet, where the water will enter to this pump. Okay, that is called your pump inlet. So we call the suction port. Now pump outlet or delivery port. So after the water is moving outward from your casing, okay, after the water throwing from the impeller and to the casing, and this casing you lift the water. So the water where it goes or lift outward, okay, moves outward from your casing, that is called your pump outlet. We also call your delivery port. Okay, next, delivery valve. So this is sometimes centrifugal pumps are fitted with one-way valve, okay, to control the flow. Okay, so that is called regulate the flows, that is called your delivery valve. Foot valve with screen. So foot valve means, so this is this water, okay, at this suction side, okay, at a water source is exposed to the atmosphere, okay, at equal to pressure is at water source is equal to atmosphere, and these are the open sources like your river, canal or anything. So here there is chances of the debris, sand or leaves, anything unwanted material. So to avoid this unwanted material, so we will provide the strainers. Okay, we provide the strainer. One way valve provided at the bottom of the suction pipe, which helps to prevent the trash from the entering into the suction pipe. That is called your foot valve. Okay, it will avoid to enter the unwanted materials in the pump. Pressure gauge. So this pressure gauge, you know, the pressure is the gauge you use to monitor, okay, check the pressure in the centrifugal pump. Okay, so this will provide at inlet suction and outlet, or we call delivery head. Okay, next, suction pressure. So what is the pressure at suction side? That is tell us the suction pressure. So we will measure the suction pressure by using the vacuum gauge. Why? So the pressure in the suction side is always or it's lesser than your atmospheric pressure. So atmospheric pressure we cannot measure with your gauge. So that's why we'll use your vacuum gauge. Okay, next, the discharge pressure. The discharge pressure is pressure at the pump discharge nozzle or outlet. Simply the pressure at outlet of the our delivery pipe, you can call that delivery pipe. So that is measured by your pressure gauge. Next, most important, it is very very important, that is your pump priming. So if you see the centrifugal pump, okay, when the water is not in the impeller, so it will rotate automatically, it rotates, and there is a vacuum is created, or that is a air, okay, so that the water will not move, okay, water will not move into the impeller. Okay, so that will add manually water to the impeller, okay, by using special provisions, so that it will avoid or make continue flow from your source to impeller. One, so that is called your priming. The operator must introduce the liquid into the system to initiate the pumping. Okay, we will add manually, that is called your pump priming. Okay, next to your total manometric head. Total manometric head means, so when the water moves from the lower section to the impeller, okay, here impeller is rotating, impeller rotates, okay, and the water is strainer and some long shaft is there, okay, the pipe are there. So these have some friction loss, some losses also takes place. So some losses in energy. So that the pump, okay, need, suppose it will pump the water up to 10.3 meters. That is your theoretical lift. But if it will lift only up to 6 to 7 meters. So what are the remaining 3 to 4 meters? So this is due to losses. So the actual head, the pump can lift. Okay, the difference, so total manometric can define the pressure difference between your pump inlet and outlet. Okay, that is H. The pressure difference between your inlet and outlet. This always higher than your actual difference between your elevation between these two points. When the pump is going run, okay, so pump need to always overcome some friction losses. Okay, some losses are there. So to overcome these losses, pump need to give some additional head. The pump also draws the water and lift from the suction to your delivery head when the pressure always more than your manometric head. Next one is your difference heads in centrifugal pump. Let us see the suction head. So this is the vertical height of your center line of your pump to your water source. So let us see this diagram. Now assume the centrifugal pump is at bottom and water source is up, little bit higher than your pump. So now the difference between your center line of your impellers, center line of impeller to your water head, this is called your static suction head. Okay, now next, static suction lift. The lift means when the water source is below, okay, and pump is above, the center line of your impeller to your water source. So this is called your static suction lift. Okay, head means when the water source is up and pump is down. So the difference between this is called your head, suction head. When the water source is bottom or below, pump is above. Now water will lift from your bottom to upside. That is called your suction lift. Similar way, the delivery head. That is similar way, the vertical distance between your center line of your pump to your target source. Okay, where the water is pumping. That is called your delivery head. Okay, next one is static head. Static head is sum of your both suction plus delivery head. Next one is most important, manometric head. The head against the centrifugal pump to work, because to avoid some friction losses, so we need to eliminate that losses so that water can be moved or pumped to target location. So total manometric head means, so this is different between your pressure at inlet and pressure at outlet. So this always higher than your actual difference. So the manometric head is always to overcome the friction losses. Okay. So this type of question may be asked in the examination. For a centrifugal pump, the suction lift is, Okay, that is the vertical distance between a free surface of a liquid, okay, in the sump to center of your pump. That is here, the center line of your impeller to the water source. That is called your suction lift. Next one, your net positive suction head of a centrifugal pump. So this is the absolute pressure head at the inlet to the pump minus the vapor pressure head plus velocity head. What exactly mean? Suppose the pump will rotate, okay, and some energy also be losses here, okay. So what is the exact pressure is needed? What is the exact head is needed so that water will enter to the impeller after avoiding the other losses or vapor? So the total net positive suction head is the actual head required to pump the water after negative, after the neglecting your vapor pressure and also the velocity head. Okay, so that we should neglect this or should avoid. Okay, and after that, whatever actual head is available, so that the water can lift from the source to the center of the pump. So that is, so the pressure or energy, required for the pump to lift, okay, water after overcoming the friction losses from the suction or nozzle. to the eye of impeller without causing vaporization. Okay, so when this will happen, when the suction pressure head at inlet is always lesser than your atmospheric pressure, so that means the suction pressure, okay, the pressure at this impeller is always lesser than the atmospheric pressure. So if this is atmospheric pressure, so this is your pressure negative or vacuum pressure, so that automatically water will move toward the center of the impeller. Okay, also here the suction pressure should not lesser than your vapor pressure of your liquid, vapor pressure of the liquid. So this is the condition most satisfied. Okay, so if the water should move, okay, water should move in the impeller when the pressure in this impeller is vacuum or lesser than the atmospheric pressure. The pressure here is atmospheric pressure, here is the vacuum pressure, and this vacuum pressure also not fall below your vapor pressure. Okay, this net positive suction head are two type. One is your net positive suction head required and available. This net positive suction head required is the minimum suction pressure that must exerted by the pump to operate correctly. So the minimum pressure required to operate the pump so that water can move from the top bottom to impeller, that is the minimum pump, minimum head is required to operate the pump. But available, so what is exactly head is available in this condition? Okay, that may be lesser, okay, there be more, so that is called what exactly available. Okay, this is required and this is available. The energy in the fluid at suction connect up your pump over all liquid vapor pressure. Okay, this is the character of your system, and this is required is depends on your pump, okay, and manufacturers. Okay, now next, so to avoid the cavitation free, so we need the pump should be operated when the net positive suction head available always more than your required. So now the centrifugal pump efficiencies. Okay, manometric efficiency, the ratio of the manometric head to the head imported by the impeller, that is simple, the whatever the power available at impeller, okay, power at impeller and water will lift, so that the manometric efficiency head by your impeller, power at impeller, the ratio of this two. Mechanical efficiency, mechanical efficiency, the pump has pump shaft and motor shaft, these are two. When the electric energy supplied from your motor to the pump, some losses are taking place. So that what is the exact power available at impeller, okay, so this impeller is connected to your shaft, the ratio of this thing, the what is the power at impeller and what is the power at shaft, the ratio of these two, and overall efficiencies. Okay, overall efficiency, that is the multiplication of your manometric head and your mechanical efficiency. So that is the, we can say the manometric efficiency, the water power by impeller, and mechanical is your impeller by shaft. If you multiply this, so we'll get, so this nothing but your what is the power available at shaft, that is P. So that with this rotation of your shaft and rotation of impeller, how much discharge will draw and how much head should be lift. Suppose this is the pump, okay, my pump, this suction head, suction, and this is the delivery. So rotation of this impeller, okay, so do rotation of this impeller and shaft, how much Q means 1000 liters, 2000 liters per second, okay, how much quantity of the dish water will draw, how much quantity of water will draw this impeller, and also how much height it will throw the water. Okay, total height may be, okay, 10 meters or 6 meter or 7 meter or 8 meter, how much height, how many meters the height will throw, that is the head, we call that head, that is called manometric head, that is against the gravity, that is called your overall efficiency. And hydraulic efficiency is the ratio of your power in fluid to impeller, so that is called your hydraulic efficiency.